Ah, jeez. I wish you could see this. Lights coming up. I've never seen a painting that captures the beauty of the ocean in a moment like this. I'm gonna make you rich, Bud Fox. You're rich enough. You can afford a girl like Darian. This is your wake-up call, pal. Go to work.
My next guest is a gold expert extraordinaire. He wrote a best-selling book. This is an updated version of the bestseller. He's got all kinds of notes at the end of all the chapters. A lot of the stuff he put in this book, I don't know, a decade ago, it came through. And, of course, the spoiler alert, you can see him right there. It's Mike Baloney of GoldSilver.com. Mike Baloney, thanks for joining us today on USAWatchdog.com.
Thanks for having me, Greg.
I've hit this vein of people. I don't really have one gold person on after another, gold expert, you know, after another. Do a lot of finance, do some politics too. But I just feel this bizarre need to have gold people on because I think we're at an inflection point. I mean, they're hammering the price of gold. It was such a bad investment. Why would you have to suppress the price? Why would you have to keep your thumb on the scale to push it down? And the other thing is you see in this stock market go to the moon and there's no there with the stock market. And we have 0.5% GDP growth. And it doesn't look like it's going to break 1% unless Donald Trump gets some major stuff done with his tax plan. What's going on with gold and silver and the stock market and all that? What is your appraisal about what's going on right now?
Well, we're basically replaying 2007 right now. We're at an inflection point where I believe you're going to see the stock markets top out this summer. There's an old saying, sell in May and go away. And, you know, when you do a study on that and you find that from October to April is where all of your gains are, if you add up all of, from 1960, if you add up all of the periods from May through September, what you find is that there's actually a net loss during that period when you average all years from 1962, I believe, is the data that I saw last. And so all of your gains come from October through April. And that suggests that the stock markets will probably peak next month or maybe the month after, maybe the month after that. I think it's going to be around May. I think you're going to see some of the debt ceiling discussion come back into the news. And that combined with all the geopolitical tension that we have these days, combined with a stock market and a real estate market that are, and a bond market that are all insane. We've got this crazy world where everything is at these valuations that are just impossible things. That will cause a peak. And then we are way overdue for a recession. Recessions occur on the average every 4.5 years. And this is, it just 2 months ago became the third longest economic expansion in the US's history. There's been 47 economic expansions and recessions. And this is now the third longest, and in 11 months, it becomes the second longest in history. So the chances of going into a recession sometime soon are very, very high. They're on the order of 90% or higher right now. And if it goes another year, it'll be like a 95 or 97% probability of a recession. And so when you couple all of these things, this insane overvaluation of the stock markets, the insane over, where, you know, if you measure real estate, the Robert Shiller real estate index, what you see is that it's back into bubbles in most major cities. We're back up at not quite 2007 levels, but still we've got, you know, in 2000, we had a stock market crash. In 2008, we had stocks and real estate. This time it's going to be stocks, real estate, and bonds. Bonds have been in a bull market for 32 years. No bull market lasts forever. Everything goes through cycles. And this has been just a perfect bull market for bonds. Sometime or another, interest rates have to rise. And whenever you manipulate, it builds up pressures and causes a greater reaction to the opposite extreme. And so the Fed has, ever since the inception of the Federal Reserve, they've manipulated the economy in general by controlling the quantity of currency in the system and the cost of that currency, the interest rates. And that is a manipulation when men sitting around a table, just a few men, decide instead of the free market with supply and demand and the price discovery mechanism setting interest rates, you've got a few men deciding based on their slide rule brained calculations. You know, these guys don't subscribe to reality. They live in this world of calculations, and they don't understand human action. Sentiment is, you know, fear, greed. This is what drives the economy. This is what drives the markets. And right now, they're raising rates, and they're taking the training wheels off just as we're starting to hit bumps in the road. You know, they had smooth pavement, and they kept stimulus going. All the world's central banks were creating all this stimulus. And now we've, the 2008 crash, that was quite a while ago. It's 9 years ago. So we're at the point now where we're going to hit big ruts and bumps, and they've just taken the training wheels off the bicycle. They should have done that ages ago. The economy would be healthy. We have the sickest, lowest increase in GDP. This is the worst economic expansion, the worst recovery in history, the entire history since 1776.
Thank you, Obamacare.
Huh?
Thank you, Obamacare.
Go to work. Okay, before I begin, I wanted to remind everyone that all gold dealers, all gold promoters, all gold pumpers, they're con men, all these guys. Every single last one of us. But the fact is, they have no credibility. They have no track record.
Today, they both have the same purchasing power. Who knows what tomorrow holds? But I know that this little gram has real intrinsic value, and it represents all the effort required to mine it. What about this 50? Nothing. The Fed runs them off the printing press. Doesn't cost much. Doesn't matter what number they put on the bill. Here's $100. There's no real difference between 150 and the same size. It costs the same amount to make this bill as that bill. They require the same effort. But if I want 100 worth of gold, I need twice as much gold. What I'm going to have to do is I'm going to have to break off another one.
Peter, sorry, buddy, in case you didn't know this, currency's intrinsic value is based upon the taxing ability of the U.S. government. And the full faith and credit of the U.S. government, and the strength of the U.S. government's economy, the strength of this nation, and the petrodollar status. It's based upon the world currency status of the dollar. It's based on many things. The intrinsic value of the dollar has no comparative counterpart in any type of currency in the world.
And they're free on goldsilver.com. Also,
yes.
You were telling me that you're going to give USA Watchdog viewers a deal. You also are a seller of gold and silver. You have some sort of deal, some sort of promo
code?
Yeah,
there's a discount if they just enter Greg Hunter, all capital letters, into the discount code. They'll get a discount on any purchase that they make.
Gold or silver coins, stuff like that.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, thank you very much, and I'll thank you for everybody that may use that. Mike Baloney, again, goldsilver.com, coming to us from Puerto Rico. Thanks for taking us to school on the Puerto Rican bond deal. Now this whole thing is going to get worse and bigger and worse, and that's your and that's really the that you agree with me. That is the canary in the coal mine for this next bond huge crash that's coming up.
Yeah, we are Greece and Puerto Rico, countries that can't, are places that can't print their own currency. They're the canary in the coal mine, saying that there's a bigger disaster going to happen. The entities that can print currency and paper over it, they are the ones that Puerto Rico and Greece are predicting will fall sometime soon. So that's it.
Okay, Mike Baloney, thank you so much for joining us today on USAWatchdog.com. Again, the website, goldmoney.com. Mike Baloney, thank you for joining us.
Goldsilver.com.
I'm so sorry. That's your competitor. I'm so sorry. But he's a good man, James Turk.
James Turk is a good friend of mine.
Yes. I'm sorry. Let's get it right now. Goldsilver.com is your website. All those hidden secrets of money are free on that site. Thank you so much again for joining me on USAWatchdog.com. Again, my penance, goldsilver.com. Mike Baloney, thanks for joining us.
Thank you, Greg.
Oh, Jesus. I wish you could see this. Lights coming up. I've never seen a painting that captures the beauty of the ocean in a moment like this. I'm gonna make you rich, Bud Fox. Yeah, rich enough you can afford a girl like Darian. This is your wake-up call, pal. Go to work.
This is a guy who is basically pointing to so-called evils in order to position his trash, which is more evil. You see the psychology here, folks. This guy's a con man. These con men are ruining a lot of people's lives, and many people don't even realize their lives are going to be ruined. They're going to see it once gold and silver continue to plunge, which they will. Okay, so back to the site now. Here I want to just go through his blog world, right? Remember I said in the past, if you want to see a bigger list of the con artists, always look at the blogs and websites that they list on their blog world, on their website. That's the network. That's their whole partnership. They're the buddy system, you understand? And you look at each one of these sites and you look at their blog world and you keep seeing the same people over and over again. You want to identify the movement, the con artist, precious metals pumping movement, the frauds. Look at these blog worlds, every single one, and you're going to see massive overlaps. You're going to see con men. Before I begin, though, I just want to mention that this Chris Duane, he does what all these other clowns, Mike Maloney and all these guys, talk about the greatest wealth transfer. It's coming. Are you going to be part of it? Folks, the greatest wealth transfer has already happened, and that was when the stock market and real estate bubble collapsed, okay? And thereafter, the soaring stock market, that's the transfer of wealth has happened. Anyway, I'm going to go through this blog roll here. SGT Report. These guys are con artists and clowns. Just another portal to pump all these gold dealers. FSN, this guy, fat Jewish loser. Most of these guys are actually Jews. They just go through the complete garbage, complete shit. Gold pumping losers. Of course you're going to see Max Kaiser. Of course you're going to see Jeff Ritz, Alex Jones. Of course you're going to see Zero Hedge. Remember, the apple never falls far from the tree. Oh, Alex Jones is a gold seller. His boss, that owns Miners Resources, they sell gold. But Alex Jones also promotes all this conspiratorial bullshit, you know, stupid lies and crap like that. Tea Party movement will fail because they have no idea what they're up against. The Tea Party movement, you know, they're funded by the Koch brothers, you dumbass. This guy doesn't even know what the hell the Tea Party is about. Loser. I'm sure he was supporting the Tea Party. This guy's such a show. And we can just go through, for instance, and check Zero Hedge's blog real quick. Click right now. And you can see, look at this, let me show you this. I mean, there you go. Chinese don't want dollars anymore. They want gold. They want gold. That's what he's saying. I mean, these con artists, and I've talked about Zero Hedge, they're a bunch of Jewish Wall Street losers who got kicked out of the industry for securities fraud. Not all of them, but at least two of them. Why do you think they're anonymous? They don't want you to know what crooks they are. Gold pumping con artists. They feature gold pumpers and other charlatans. They don't have anyone credible on here, ever. Why? Because look at the ads they're selling. They want to lure that gold crowd, the moron crowd. Same bullshit. These are the same guys that feature Peter Schiff, Mike Maloney, Chris Martinson. They talk about the dollar collapsing. I mean, come on, seriously, people, wake the f*** up. You missed out on the biggest stock market rally in 70 years. More than 70 years. And you're still falling for this shit while gold plunges and silver plunges? I mean, when are you going to wake up? No credibility. I mean, just read these headlines. J.P. Morgan, quiet scramble to refill its gold ball. I mean, somebody, please. I'm hoping that there are people out there who have lost their ass and understand why they lost their ass in gold and silver. It's because you were fed lies and sensationalist bullshit from Max Koch, from Alex Jones, from Peter Schiff, from Zero Hedge, from Mike Maloney, from Chris Duane, from Jensen Sinclair, from Eric Sprung, from all these guys. And I hope that you go after them. I want to hear about it on the news. Look, Stratfor, he's got Stratfor on the mouth, right? This is the Israeli-run agency in Austin, which has connections to Alex Jones. They work for this, they're funded by Mossad. I mean, wow. Okay, so the final thing I'm going to go over is the must-read books. These are must-read books, of course. And you can get an idea about someone by the books they say you must read. Now, I mentioned this before, and for those of you who don't know this, I suggest that you look at my track record and the video I made about the just one chapter of America's Financial Apocalypse. Anyone who has a website who is not talking about that book, who's not listing it as a must-read, as the top must-read, is a moron or a con artist. That's a fact. Okay? And if you are familiar with the contents of America's Financial Apocalypse, you'll understand why. So you need to call out these guys and ask them, why don't you have America's Financial Apocalypse on the reading list? Is it because status speaks the truth, he has credibility? Is it because they say you need to trade gold and silver, you don't need to stay in it forever? Is it because they say don't buy physical gold and silver? Trade the ETFs? Why? Why? Always ask why. And you just go through all these books. I mean, they're a joke. These books are all written by either wackos, idiots, or con men. Every single one of them. Every single one of them. I mean, anybody who reads this Aaron Rand is just a fucking wacko idiot. Currency Wars, Rickers, this guy's a moron. I'm going to feature him pretty soon. I've done a few videos on him. I haven't had a chance to edit them. This guy's a clown. Jekyll Island, Evan Griffith basically, according to Eustace Mullins, plagiarized Eustace Mullins and whitewashed the material, didn't talk about the Jewish connection to the Federal Reserve. Eustace Mullins, of course, came out with his book on the Federal Reserve. The original definitive book was written about at least 30 or 40 years before Griffith. But of course, Griffith gets all the credit. Why? Because Griffith whitewashed all the Jewish stuff. You see? So you don't hear about Griffith. These guys are all idiots. I wouldn't waste my time on a single one of these books. Garbage. Every single one of them. Every single one. Empire of Debt. You know what's funny about this stupid book? Bill Bonner, the guy that runs Agora Financial, scam financial publishing company. Porter Stansberry worked there. I mean, you can just go down all the list of people that have been sued by the SEC. Complete clowns pumping out bullshit. Well, this book was written by Bonner, I believe in like 2005 or 2004. I think it was 2004 when the debt was like, I don't know, $4 trillion. And you say, oh my God, the debt's going to collapse us. What an idiot. Bill Bonner's an idiot. He knows he missed the collapse. He was crying about the debt in 2004 when it was tiny compared to today. And the debt didn't do shit. He missed everything. Of course, this guy's going to have Peter Schiff's bullshit book on there, Robert Prechter, all these bullshit books. I mean, seriously. If you lost money with any of these guys, especially if they're a brokerage firm. If you want to get it back, contact me. Contact me with the amount of losses, where it was from, when it was done, and I need your account statement as well. And by the way, for those of you who fallen into the game of ultra-conservative investments, bearish-type investments, right? In other words, guys like Mike Shedlock, who's three- or four-man firm, they preach low risk. So basically, you're getting like a 4 or 5% return maybe. The market's up 30% for the year. You missed out. You can also get your money. You can sue his firm, him, for those losses. So I know that whole industry. I worked on Wall Street, and no one talks about this. If you've got substantial money that you've lost, email me, and I can help you get your money back. Chance that gold is going to test this 140. But if gold hits, 140-ish, I would definitely be selling it. And it might even, depending upon what type of trader you are, kind of profit you made in trading gold, I would look for a sign, a trigger catalyst to even short it. And that catalyst would be, some type of an important downward move. And also, you might want to consider what's going on with the dollar and with the U.S. stock market as a part of that catalyst, right? You're going to see the stock market start to gain some strength, and you've got that gold at 140, and it looks like it's hesitating or even weakening, then I think that would be a pretty good catalyst to put a short position in, definitely a sell position.
I'm losing my mind.
Stay away from the media. You're going to get screwed. That is a fact. The problem is that for those of you who hate the bankers, who hate the Federal Reserve, hate the financial industry, hey, I'm in the same camp. But that doesn't mean that you go for the alternative. That doesn't mean just because you don't like the Federal Reserve's control over the U.S. dollar, doesn't mean that you align yourself with the guys that are talking about it being bad and buy gold. They're trying to exploit you. The Fed is bad. Buy gold from me, I'll charge you 10%, right? So don't take that simpleton mentality. Don't fall into that trap. Just because you have someone out there calling out the criminals doesn't mean they're not criminals. And as a matter of fact, and I've told this to people recently, if it's the establishment versus the alternative guys out there, stick with the establishment. You're going to suffer much less, I guarantee you.
Wow, Jesus. I wish you could see this. Light's coming up. I've never seen a painting that captures the beauty of the ocean in a moment like this. I'm gonna make you rich, Bud Fox. Yeah, rich enough you can afford a girl like Terry. This is your wake-up call, pal. Go to work.
I see in my last video, Why $15,000 Gold is Possible, Mike Maloney, author of Rich Dad's Guide to Investing in Gold and Silver, predicts $15,000 gold. But Mike says silver actually makes the better investment.
Once the common man turns towards silver because gold is too expensive, that's when the price would explode. And I believe in either scenario, it's going to blow the doors off of gold.
Mike says $15,000 gold means $1,500 silver.
Silver's value was about 1/12 of gold's value. And today we're at about 1/65. It should revert back to the mean. It should probably overshoot for a little while. You may see silver at 1/10 of gold's value or 1/5. If it went to 1/10, that means $1,500 silver from just $18. I'm not guaranteeing that that's going to happen. These are just numbers. But I do expect, you know, in 1980 it was 1/16 of gold's price. I'm expecting better than 1/16, most likely better than 1/10. So, and 1/10 would mean $1,500 silver. That's a lot, I know. I don't expect it to stay there. Silver's mining costs are significantly below gold's. But mining costs have nothing to do with public fear or mania.
But so- the next billionaire is going to be you. I am holding in my hand.
If you're a good pitcher, there are suckers out there.
I am holding in my hand the most innovative, precious metal product I've ever seen. This is a whole valve.
The bridge stands still around. It was from Mike Maloney. I caught up with this Mike Maloney. He's a fucking scam. Do not buy from Mike Maloney. He's a fucking scam.
You are going to get the spot.
You better learn to love it.
He said silver was going to go to 1,500. It didn't even go to 100. And he's still pushing silver. It's the best investment in the world. All you poor people buying this shit, you're not going to get rich. You're not going to get any richer. So sell now.
Filthy rich.